QED, a series of educational courses. Please like and share this video and subscribe for more promotions of the videos. Thank you. So let us discuss the solution of this question number 1. Now in this question, we have given the function defined by these three formulas for three pieces of the values of x. Now in the such type of function, to find the continuity or discontinuity, we have to find the turning point from these three pieces. So it is noted that. So in this video lecture, we will discuss some of the solution of the questions related to the continuity of the topic, specifically continuity of the piecewise function. What is piecewise function? A function in which we define different formulas for different pieces of its domain. For example, for the function in question number 1, f of x is defined by three pieces. The first piece, the first formula x plus 4 for the range of the values from minus 6 to minus 2, and then x for the second piece of the range, and then x minus 4 for the third piece of the range. The first one is minus 2, because we can see that for values of x to the left of minus 2 and to the right of minus 2, the function is defined by two formulas. To left side we have x plus 4, and on the right side we have x. And similarly, the second turning point is x is equal to 2, because function is defined by x for left side of 2, and similarly for right side of 2, function is defined by x minus 4. So here x is equals to minus 2 and x is equals to 2 are the turning point. So we shall discuss the continuity at these two points. Let us take the first point, x is equals to minus 2, and check the continuity of this function at this point. So here we have the first condition to find the value of the function at this point, x is equals to minus 2. So we can see that minus 2 is included in the second piece, which is minus 2 is less than equals to x, means x is equals to minus 2 or more than 2, minus 2. So the function is defined by the formula x. So we shall simply put x is equals to minus 2. This is our value of the function at x is equals to minus 2. Now let us find out the limit of this function. Since function is piecewise, so we shall find out the left and right hand limits of the function. The left hand limit of the function, indicated by f of minus 2 minus 0, a notation for left hand limit, can also be written in this form: limit x tends to minus 2, superscript minus, or minus 2 minus 0, to the function f of x, a notation for left hand limit. Now we can see that among the three different formulas for different pieces, for the function to the left side of 2 is x plus 4. So when you apply the limit x tends to minus 2 minus from the left side of the function x minus 4, you will get minus 2 minus 0 and then plus 4. So when you apply the limit, you will get 2. This is your left hand limit of this function. Now let us find out the right hand limit of this function. The right hand limit in similar way can be obtained by not writing the notation f of minus 2 plus 0, and then in the limiting form we can write this as limit x tends to minus 2 plus 0 f of x. So here function to the right of x, that is minus 2, is defined by x. So we shall simply write here x. So when you apply the limit, you will get minus 2. Now as we see that the value of the function is minus 2, 8 point minus 2, and then the left hand limit is plus 2, and similarly the right hand limit is minus 2. Further, we can also note that Note that the left hand limit of the function, that is f of 2 minus 2, is not equals to the right hand limit of the function. So hence we can say that the limit of the function at point minus 2 does not exist. So function f of x has discontinuity at x is equals to minus 2. So similarly, we can take another point. Similarly, let us discuss the continuity of the function at a point x is equals to 2 to see whether function is continuous or discontinuous at the given point. So in a similar manner, we will find the value of the function at the point x is equals to 2. Now we see that since in the third piece, the function is defined by x minus 4 for the range of values of x, that is 2 less than or equals to x. So here we 2 is included in this interval. So when you put here x is equals to 2 into the third formula, we will have 2 minus 4 will be equals to minus 2. And when you find out the left hand limit of the function at point 2, so we see that to the left of x is equals to 2, to the left side of 2, the function is defined by x. So what we do, we write the notation for left hand limit at point 2, and then we write limit x tends to 2 minus 0 f of x. Now if you replace the function f of x for the values of x left side of 2 or less than 2, replacing function f of x by x as given here, so when you apply the limit, you will get 2. In similar manner, we can also compute the right hand limit of the function by writing f of 2 plus 0 as a notation, and then limit x tends to 2 plus 0 for right hand limit of the function f of x. So when you replace this function, limit x tends to 2 plus 0, now we see that on the right side of 2, means values of 2 larger than values of x larger than 2, we have the function defined by x minus 4. So this will be equals to x minus 4 over function right side of 2 or larger values of 2. So when you apply the limit, you will get 2 minus 4 is equals to minus 2. So once again we see that the left hand limit of the function at point 2, which is 2, and similarly the right hand limit of the function at point 2, it is f of 2 plus 0 is minus 2. So these two are not equal, which implies that limit of the function does not exist. So hence this is the condition of continuity, that value of the function is equal to the limit of the function. Since the limit does not exist, so function is discontinuous. So we can write limit x tends to 2 to the function f of x does not exist, which implies that function f of x has discontinuity at x is equals to 2. So finally what we conclude, that function has discontinuity at the two turning point minus 2 and plus 2. On the other values, function is continuous. Now let us take our second question. A source of provide voltage to a circuit according to the piecewise function defined by V of t, defined by 0 for t less than 0 and t for t more than or equals to 0. Discuss the point of continuity of V. Now note that in this function is defined by two piece by the formula 0 for the piece t less than 0, means values of r which are less than or left side of 0 and defined by t when it is of t are larger or equals to 0. So again we have to check our turning point. As we can see that to the left and right of t is equals to 0, function is defined by different formula. So here we can indicate that our turning point is t is equals to 0. So we shall test our continuity of this function at this point. So similar manner as we did the last example, we find the value of the function at point 0. So we can see that the second piece we can obtain the value of function at point 0. When you put t is equal to 0, you will get 0. In similar manner, we can find out the left hand limit of the function. So that will be the limit t tends to 0 minus 0 to the function v of t. Now this function to the values of t less than 0 or left side of 0 is defined by simply 0. When you apply the limit, you will get 0. In similar manner, we can also find out the right hand limit. So limit t tends to 0 plus 0 to the function v of t. So this function to the right hand of t is defined by simply linear function, that is t. So when you apply the limit, we will get again 0. So what we see that the value of the function at point 0 is equals to the left hand limit of the function at point 0 is equals to the right hand limit of the function at point 0, which means that the function v of t satisfies the condition of continuity. The function v of t is continuous function. At t is equals to 0, and hence all values of t. Now I have written here all values of t, which means that since at point t is equal to 0 function is continuous, it simply means that the dangerous point or turning point, if the function is continuous, this means function is continuous at all of the point of t. So this function is continuous function. This function is continuous function for all values of the real numbers t. Now let us see the cost function, the monthly charge for x kilowatt hours of the electricity used by commercial customer is given by the cost function. Now this function is 4-piece function defined by 18.52 plus 0.1086 into x. If 0 is less than x, less than or equals to 7. The second formula, the function is defined by 17.79 plus 0.1239 into x. If 7 is less than x, less than equals to 77. The third piece, the function is defined by the formula 22.34 plus 0.1056 into x. If 77 is less than x, less than or equals to 160. And finally the function is defined by 22.45 plus 0.0321 into x. If x is more than 160. So now from the last two examples, can you identify what we have to do here? How we can test the point of discontinuity or the continuity of this function? So to find the cost of electricity for x is equals to 5. Now in this example we have to see that as x is equals to 5 lie in the first interval, that is from 0 to 7, So we will use the first piece of the function to find the value of the function at the point x is equals to 5. So when you put x is equals to 5 into the first piece, we have 18.52 plus 0.1086 x, replace x by 5, simplify, you will get the value or the cost of consuming the 5 kilowatt hour of electricity will be 19.06 units, whatever the unit may be, rupees or dollars as well, whatever. In similar manner, we can also find out the value of consuming the 9 kilowatt hour of the units. So again, for finding the 9 kilowatt hour, we can see that now the value of x 9 lie in the second piece, that is from 7 to 77. So we shall use second formula, and finally you will get the value will be equals to, that is 18.9051. and similar value we will get values of the cost by consuming x, that is 100 kilowatt hour, from the third piece of the function or third formula, that is 32.9. So this was the part A for finding the values of the function when x is equals to 5, 9 and 10, or we can also say that cost of consuming the electricity 5 kilowatt hour, 9 kilowatt hour and 100 kilowatt hours of units. Now second part of this problem is to find or mention the values of x where function is continuous. So now again we shall look for the turning point. So we can see that the turning points are 7, 77 and then 160. These are the point to which the left and right function is defined by different formulas. So x is equals to 7, 77 and 160 are turning point. These are the point where function has stopped to be continuous. So we shall discuss continuity at this point. So let us take the first point, x is equals to 7. To put value of x is equals to 7 into the function, so as we see that the value of x is equals to 7, the function is defined by the first piece, that is 18.52 plus 0.1086 into x. So substitute the values of this function. Substitute the value at the first piece of the function for value of x is equals to 7. When you simplify, you will get 19.2802. Similarly, the left hand limit, that is limit x tends to 7 minus 0 to the function c of x. So here we can use a function which contain the left side or the values of x smaller than 7. Get the first piece, that is 18.52. So just replace c of x by 18.52 plus 0.1086. So when you apply the limit, you will get 19.2802. Now let us find out the right hand limit. So for right hand limit, we just replace x by 7 plus 0 for notation of the right hand limit, and then we write it equals to limit x tends to 7 plus 0 to the function c of x. Now in this case, the function is defined by second piece for the larger values of x larger than 7. This function is defined by 17.79 plus 0.1239 into x. So when you apply the limit to this function, you will get 18.6573. Now notice here that the left hand limit of the function, that is 19.2802, is not equals to the right hand limit of the function, that is 18.6573, so which implies that the limit of the function as x tends to 7 does not exist. Which also means that this condition of the one of the condition of the credulity fails, hence the function c of x has discontinuity at point x is equals to 7. Hence the point x is equals to 7 is the point of discontinuity. In similar way, we can also try to find the continuity of the function at the point x is equals to 77 and then x is equals to 160, and finally what will you get? That the function c of x, and you will get that function c of x has discontinuity at x is equals to 7, 77 and 160. So these are the point of discontinuity. So now what we conclude, that the other point of x are point of continuity. So all the other points of x is equals to 7 are the point of continuity. Now suppose that we have given a function t of t defined by two p's. The first p is the formula 20 t, when the value of t is less than or equals to 60, and then formula for second piece of the function, that is k minus 30 t, for values of t larger than or more than 60. And here we have to find the value of k such that given function is continuous, or t is continuous. So how to solve such type of question, how to find the value of k? So let us see this. For this function, it is given that function is continuous at t equals 60. So first we shall find the conditions of continuity, and then we shall simplify to find the value of k. So let's start with the first condition to find the value of the function when x is t equals 60 in this function. So when t equals 60, the value of the function can be obtained from the first piece, that is 20 into t. So replace t by 60 and simplify, you will get . Now let us find the limit of the function. So left hand limit of this function, that is t of 60 minus 0, can also be written in this form of t tends to 60 minus 0 from left side of 60 or smaller than 60. So finding the limit t tends to 60 minus 0. So this t of t has the formula 20 t for the values of t smaller than 60. So we can replace this t of t by 20 t. When you apply the limit, you will get 1200. Now similar way, we find out the right hand limit of this function, indicated by t of 60 plus 0. That is the limit
T tends to 60 plus 0 to the function T of T. Now the formula for the values of T larger than 60 or right hand of 60 is K minus 30 T. So when you put here K minus 30 T and apply the limit, then you will get K minus 1800. As we have given that the function is continuous, so which also means that the limit of the function will also be this, and that will be equal to the value of the function. So if you take only the limit portion, the limit, the left hand limit of the function must be equal to the right hand limit of the function if the function is continuous. So from here the left hand limit is 1200 and the right hand limit is k minus the 1800. So from here when you simplify, you will get the value of k will be equal to 100 plus the 1800, and that is equals to 3000. So this is the value of k. When you substitute into the function in this place, then the function will be continuous.